Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Idle Moon Rabbit AFK RPG on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Idle Moon Rabbit AFK RPG and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Idle Moon Rabbit AFK RPG. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all mates, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL I'm highlighting in green color. Now, you are able to see on the PC screen. You don't need to type it, simply because I provided a link in the description of this video and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed right here on the website of Usitility, at which we have a nice in-depth demonstration on how to download Idle Moon Rabbit AFK RPG on laptop or computer. We scroll down a little bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on the link, we get to the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to this game Idle Moon Rabbit AFK RPG on PC. As you can see from here, we access a number of advantages of using that emulator. Now we will start downloading the Idle Moon Rabbit AFK RPG by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. We then click on it. And the download takes no time at all. Here it is, here is located the download. It is an executable file. What we are going to do is to run the installer, so we have to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the computer. We clicked yes. I minimize the browser to find the installer significantly better. The installer is really easy to understand. It contains a couple of options, install, and setup path. I will describe what setup path really does. We simply click on it. So we observe that we have now here the path where in fact the emulator is going to be put in. If we desire to change this directory, we have got to click on that browse button, and we choose another folder and set up the emulator where we like. To keep it simple, just set it where it is. Then, I click on back. So I simply click on install. Voila! The installation begins and it is going to continue in the download of those megabytes that happens to be shown on the computer screen. The moment you save it on your hard drive, it may be more or less MB. The data transfer rate may go faster or at a lower speed, determined by your type of access to the web and according to the speed capacity of the emulator hosting servers. Right away they're progressing superbly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this moment, the emulator has been started instantly. As you can observe, down here, there's a progress bar that will fill up when it gets to the ending, the emulator will be launched for the very first time. The truth is the emulator was already started, there for the first time. Before we carry on, as you can observe, it has made a couple of icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is the one we're interested in. Whenever we would like to run Idle Moon Rabbit AFK RPG on the desktop or laptop, we double-click on this specific software icon and therefore run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Why don't we perform the following step, that is a requirement, and which is to entry the Google Play Store. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As you can observe, the Google Play is launched. Right here we need to log on. At this point, as soon as we're there, we must definitely begin doing the next phase, which is mandatory. Therefore click on Sign In. At this moment it says, checking info. It could from time to time get blocked in checking info, and so it doesn't continue. If that's the case, you could attempt to log in and after a couple of hours, but it will surely most certainly be sorted out. At this moment we will insert our login name and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email and its corresponding password. For instance, you can use the same email you're using at this moment in your own YouTube account. So that I am going to enter my info and I'll go back immediately after I have accomplished it. That's it, details typed in. Discover Google welcoming us and providing us their twos. We will accept them by just clicking on, I agree. Following, it offers us to save to the Google Cloud. You could let it select it and it'll create a backup of your data files on this device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you do what you want. We simply click on accept. Google Play Store is launched automatically and instantly. To set up the app, we have to go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking the icon marked in green. Right now that we are watching the desktop of this emulator for Android, we observe that we have now right here the install video game button. We click on that button. There we get the game app. Why don't we simply click right here on the install option that I'm highlighting now in green color. And this will begin the software installation. At present it is going to download on your desktop or laptop and install the game. It may take quite some time or it may be very fast. It again all is dependent upon on our own internet connection. It has by then completed setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by hitting this particular button that I'm showing in green, to be able to launch Idle Moon Rabbit AFK RPG for the first time. We're by now on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are on the way to just click on this fresh Idle Moon Rabbit AFK RPG icon that has been generated. This video game is started for the first time. Currently there we get it, I could click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should comment on the volume level of that emulator. It is right here, we have got the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume, this way we will not use the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. And to enjoy the experience to the maximum, we could switch on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. This is the first one, we mouse click on this particular software icon that I am pointing out in green. And the screen is maximized, coming with one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In the event that we really want to experience the video game using all the screen, we press on this icon. And we'd at present be experiencing and enjoying the video game in 100% screen setting. To leave the complete screen mode, press the F11 key. Then we would likely at present play in normal display screen setting. At present, I am starting to present you the computer keyboard mapping that is really extremely useful. This way we will likely be able to use the game far more effortlessly. The first thing is to click on this software icon. It's now time to get the required controls. Let me keep the normal configuration, but if you need to change it, you can do this without having problem. Obviously, the emulator is totally in our own language. On occasion it happens that your emulator is started in the incorrect language, for example, in Chinese. And then to set it in the proper language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then here inside of additional controls, we just click on the language drop down. We can also choose the language we want, German, Mandarin, etc. Once the language is chosen, we are going to save, the emulator will restart, and the game application, next time we use it, will as well be in the preferred language. At this point, there's another element that we will need to take into consideration, and it's that we will receive a message from Google saying that a new electronic device has been connected to our Google account. It will likely ask us if we're the people who have connected that device. Yup, we really should not get worried, considering that the emulator is behaving like in Google Android smartphone or tablet. In order to discover which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we go right here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. Therefore we go here to the model choice. And right here we determine that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for that training. I sincerely hope you enjoyed it, particularly that you found it informative. If that is so, give it a good like, subscribe to my channel, and any remarks, questions or suggestions, put them in the comment area down below. You could possibly also comment things on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams on occasion, you get it down below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Simply click any of those video tutorials that happens to be appearing on the screen and let's have fun again in the following video tutorials. Bye.